Hi, thanks for watching. This video is actually part of a greater series comparing features between Magento and Shopware. In this lesson, I'm actually going to focus upon controllers. So I'm assuming that you know how a controller fits in into any kind of application. We're not going to talk about that. And I'm not even going to introduce how to put together your own controller in Magento. But I'm going to show those steps anyway, just to make the comparison between what you need to do to put together a controller in Magento and how to accomplish that same task in Shopware itself. So in Magento, the whole thing starts basically with registering not a controller class, but actually registering your own root. That's being done by coming up with this roots.xml file, and it could be either be created for the front end or for the back end. That also means that for the front end, we're going to choose specifically the router called ID is standard. And then within that standard router, I'm actually going to add my own route so that any URL with the front name starting with example, meaning a URL like example/index/index, is actually going to be picked up by my own module. Now, as you can see, there's a connection between the module and the route name, in this case, the example front name. But there's not a strong relation between the URLs and the controller itself, or at least it's not done by an exact configuration within the XML. So instead, actually, every time when there's this prefix of the URL example slash, then everything that comes after that URL boils down to be part of the naming standard of a specific controller and even the path that is existing in. So how to do that? Basically, there's this controller folder within your own module. And within that controller folder, there's this path folder, the in this case index. And within that specific folder, within that specific namespace, I'm simply going to create a class called index. I'm going to do this in a new style of Magento 2.4, implementing a certain action interface. And then actually it boils down to me creating also an execute function so that every time when this class is being called upon, or actually when the URL example/index/index is going to be called upon, then actually I'm going to execute this execute method. And what am I going to do? I'm actually going to return yet another class or another object called the result page. The result page is put together using this result page factory, but the end result is that I'm actually building this front-end controller that is rendering the page in total. So that's basically the procedure in Magento. So first of all, there's this piece of XML and then a PHP class. But within the XML, I'm correlating the start of the URL with my own module, while actually the specific URL example/index/index boils down to also kind of like a guessing scheme or a naming convention that boils down to the path towards this specific class, in this case, index/index. So let's actually compare this with Shopware. Because actually in Shopware, it's happening in quite a different way, but it's interesting to see some correspondence there as well. For instance, to declare your own route, we're not putting anything together in the XML itself. However, it is needed to add this file called routes.xml so that all of the controllers that are actually going to do the magic that I'm going to explain in a bit, all of those controller classes are being picked up. So there's this route definition file, which is including an import. And what are we importing? Well, basically all of the different files by going down one level and then yet another level and then going up one level to the controller folder. So basically it boils down to the source folder within your own module /controller/, and then any kind of file ending with controller.php. And the reason why that PHP file or PHP files are being imported are basically because of their PHP annotation. So Symfony and therefore Shopware itself as well is making heavy use of annotations to do things. Not everywhere, but specifically here for routing, it's really important. What is the annotation all about? Well, within this PHP controller, we can see that the controller itself is extending upon yet another class called storefront controller, but I'll get back to that in a moment. But the annotation itself is actually written as PHP commands within the class just above the public function show page. You can see that there's a route scope and a route being defined. Well, both route scope and route are also imported as namespaces a little bit above that. They're part of the Symfony framework, but through the route scope, I'm declaring that this controller is not an admin controller. It's not an API controller. It's specifically a storefront controller. As soon as I navigate to the route or the URL called /swag/example, then actually this function is going to be executed. Also, in the previous example, I played around with Magento rendering a specific page. And to do that, I'm actually extending upon this storefront controller so that I'm simply calling upon a method of that extent of that parent class. And that method is render storefront with an argument pointing to a specific Twig template. And that's basically how the whole rendering is taking place. Comparing these two different procedures, well, the code is quite a bit different. So within XML, we actually put things together by injecting our own route definition with the URL and everything, all of the information attached to it within XML. While actually with Shopware, the configuration of the route itself is not within XML. XML is only used to import basically a specific PHP class annotation. And then through that annotation, the route itself is defined. So basically, the most important thing to know about controllers in Symfony or in Shopware are basically to know about the route scope and the route annotations, as you can see right here in the comments just above the method. But still, the comparison is kind of nice to also note that simply by putting together your own controller, extending upon or implementing upon some kind of parent behavior, and then putting everything together by using that XML, it's just two separate steps, XML and then PHP, to put that all together. In that way, you can see that, well, basically Magento and Shopware are still kind of comparable to each other. The main thing where Symfony and Shopware, therefore, are really different is because of those annotations. So that basically is also a little thing that you need to know once you dive deeper into Shopware. Always be aware of the PHP commands holding additional information picked up by the service container to do all kinds of stuff. But yeah, that's it for the comparison. Hopefully you can compare the two and that at least you've seen one example of how to put together your own page controller, rendering a page through a simple controller task. Still, other lessons are going to dive deeper into how to put together your own controller, how to inject dependencies the right way into your own controllers, and also how to put different controllers to tasks. So there's API controllers, there's administration controllers, and there's the storefront controller that I've just shown you. So there's more to controllers, but at least now there's a little bit of getting started for you if you're already familiar with Magento and you want to get going with Shopware. So thanks for listening, and hopefully, stay tuned for the other lessons comparing bits and pieces between Magento and Shopware. See you in a bit.